Apologies from Tanner. Tanner was supposed to join you in person today, but he has COVID. So he's doing okay, but he's sorry that he couldn't join you.
Yeah, 所以说今天我们原本要邀请到的是大家非常熟悉的这个 Tanner Gibb， 他是做这个我们华贸培训非常非常流利的一位专家，但是呢，他不幸在来的前一天不幸被测试出新冠，所以他也觉得很遗憾。不过呢，他现在身体没有问题，已经在家休息了。
I just wish he got sick a little bit earlier so that I could have had time to fly to New York and be there myself.
Absolutely. 所以说呢 ，Mark 刚刚就讲说，他其实希望说 ，Tanner 如果当时可以测试出早一点，这样他就有时间可以飞过来和大家亲自做这个培训。
Okay, I'm going to share my screen, okay? And let's start talking about some pretty cool stuff here.
Perfect.
All right, you see that okay?
Yes.
Fantastic. Okay, so I think we have an hour to talk about our latest, most exciting science.
Yes. So Mark, you have 30 minutes, but I will translate.
Right, so
okay,、awesome.
one hour total or 30 minutes total?
Absolutely. 所以说呢，我们在接下来 Mark 会讲，然后呢，我们会翻译。好 ，Thank you.
Alright, well, you just tell me when to stop.
You can. It's you are free to start whenever you're ready.
Alright. So we have a really good team of scientists at Nu Skin. There are about 30 PhDs, and a big part of our team is actually in Shanghai.
所以说呢，我们如今有一个非常优秀的这个科学家团队，大概有将近30人，是这个博士的这个有博士学位的科学家。那很大一部分呢，实际上他们在上海。
So sometimes we work on projects for several years before you see what we have done, and this is one of those projects.
所以很多时候呢，我们很多产品做科研的时候，实际上是会在产品上市很多年之前就已经开始了这样子的科研研究啊，但是要很多年以后大家才有可能会看到这个产品的上市。
So we have our team of scientists. About 20 years ago, I remember sitting with our team of scientists and our scientific advisory board, and we were talking about metabolic health.
所以说呢 ，Mark 记得说，这在20多年前，他和他们的这个科学家团队，还有他们的这个科研的这个小组坐在一起，然后呢，有聊到这个这个新陈代谢健康。
And scientists were just starting to be concerned about this problem of metabolism or metabolic health.
所以说那个时候呢，科学家才刚刚开始对人们的这个新陈代谢健康感到了一些忧虑，发现了一些问题。
And they had sort of a new name. They were calling it different things like metabolic syndrome or syndrome X.
那个时候呢，他们这个会把它叫做不同的名字啊，有些人呢叫做这个新陈代谢健康状况，或者叫做新陈代谢 X.
And of course, at PharmaNex, one of the reasons why our scientists get together is because we try to solve the problem. We try to solve any kind of health and wellness issues to see if there's anything that nature can provide to help with human wellness.
所以说呢，科学家他们的任务，他们想要做的就是去发现问题以后，要想一个办法可以解决，可以去改善这样子的问题。
So this slide really sums up the problem. Like 90% of consumers agree that our modern lifestyles are taking some kind of a toll on our bodies. Maybe we don't know what it is, but we know that our modern lifestyle is really tough.And it must be having some impact.
所以说呢，有90%的这个消费者同意说，他们现在的这种现代的这个生活方式对他们的身体造成了一些影响。他们不知道这些影响是什么，但是他们只是觉得说，哎，有这样子的问题。
And in fact, it does. You can see here from a very recent study that only 1 in 8 people in the USA is considered to be metabolically healthy.
所以说呢，在近期的一个研究里面表明说，在美国，这个是在美国，每8个人当中就会有只有一个人表示说他们的这个新陈代谢，他们认为的新陈代谢是健康的。
So we have to ask then, what is metabolic health?
所以说呢，这个时候我们就要提问，这个新陈代谢的这个健康到底是什么？
When you talk to the average American, or actually around the world, when you say metabolism, people really think of fast metabolism or slow metabolism.
那当你问到这个普通人，在美国甚至在全世界，当你问他到这个新陈代谢的时候，他们只会想到说新陈代谢快或者新陈代谢慢。
And so most people are thinking, ah.If my metabolism is fast, that means I'm going to be skinny and healthy. And if my metabolism is slow, maybe that means I will be overweight.
所以说呢，大家就会觉得说，如果我新陈代谢快的话，那我一定是很瘦很健康。如果我新陈代谢慢的话，那我有可能会是有点过重或者说不健康。
But that is a big oversimplification of what metabolic health really means.
但实际上这个是一个过于简单的一个理解，因为这个新陈代谢健康不仅仅只局限于速度的快和慢。
See, metabolism actually is a much bigger picture.
那新陈代谢实际上是一个很，实际上比这个快和慢要多很多，是一个更大的一个图谱。
Metabolism is actually all, every single one of all of the biochemical reactions that are happening in the body.
那新陈代谢实际上是我们这个身体的这个化生物化学的一个过程，所有生物化学的过程都代表着这个新陈代谢的过程。
So it's not just all of the reactions that convert the food that you eat into energy.
所以它并不只是代表说我把这个吃进去的这个食物转变成能量。
But essentially, it's all of the chemical reactions that.Can create and maintain the human body, all of its systems.
而是你的身体里面所有的这个生物化学过程，把你的这个体内的去把你吃的食物转化成你体内所有器官需要的能量，需要的这个化学物质。
Now our doctors, they want us to be healthy. So when you go to the doctor for your checkup every year.They do things, right? Like they do tests to make sure your health is good.
所以说呢，当每年你去这个我们的医生，我们的个人医生都希望大家健康。所以说呢，每次你去体检的时候，这个医生就会测试各种指标。
What they're really doing is looking for indicators that show the health of your metabolic systems or your biochemistry.
但实际上呢，他们只是在看，哎，说你这个人是不是健康？实际上呢，他们是在看这个指标，是看这个你整个新陈代谢健康的新陈代谢系统健康的这个指标。
So they'll often do a blood draw. We all just love that when they stick a needle in our arm, right?
所以说呢，我们都非常喜欢每一次这个医生去测试之后呢，就开始往你身上扎针，大家都很喜欢哈。
When they do that, they're looking for three main things.
那当他们去抽血化验的时候呢，他们主要是要找三个东西。
The first is blood lipids.
第一个是。
Or blood fats.
血脂，他首先看血脂。
Right, so like cholesterol, you know, LDL, HDL, triglycerides.
所以比方说这个胆固醇还有这个甘油三酯。
They also look for blood sugar. How is your body controlling the sugar that goes into your body?
它还会看血压，就是你的身体对你血压的调节如何。血糖，不好意思，血糖。
Yeah, so the doctors have this list of things that are markers of your metabolic health.
所以说呢，这个医生就会看这个很多这个指标是你的这个新陈代谢健康的这个指标。
And if things are not good, then the doctor will probably give you some advice.
如果说呢有哪一个指标不 OK, 那这个你的医生就会给你一些建议。
But really, when it boils down to it, there are things about our modern life that make the body biochemistry sort of go bad and become unhealthy.
所以说呢，在我们现代的这个生活方式中，实际上呢，基本上总结出几个是让你的这个新陈代谢健康，对你的新陈代谢健康造成问题的。
So maybe this list looks familiar to you. All of the things that we do that are not healthy that could disrupt our metabolic health.
所以说呢，现在这个活动的这个列表，大家看起来一定不陌生。这个呢，是对我们这个新陈代谢健康会造成非常大的不益。但是呢，你可能经常会做的，比方说这个久坐不动，就是不断的在我们在追剧。成日成夜的追剧，然后呢，我们会熬夜啊，晚睡早起，然后呢，有可能你也会工作，一次性工作很长时间，啊，对你的这个周围的，你的这个周围的这个啊财务啊，或者是你的这个个人关系，对你的这个健康造成影响。还有呢，就是可能会你吃的这个啊营养不良。
I'm sure you can all relate, right? Especially if you live in New York.
所以说大家一定都可以体会，特别是如果你在纽约生活的话。
Yeah, we don't have this problem in Provo, Utah. It's just a small
thing. 所以我们生活在 Provo, Utah, 我们没有这样子的压力。
All right, so here's another thing. So, metabolic health is usually less good if you are overweight.
所以这个新陈代谢健康很多时候，如果说你啊。Sorry, can you repeat that one more time?
Yeah, so if somebody is very overweight, usually then you will, you know, have very obviously poor metabolic health.
所以如果有一个人他的这个脂啊、是体重超重的话，他很有可能这个在他的新陈代谢方面是不健康的。
But it's not just for people who are overweight, because the studies, as you can see here, show.That even 2/3 of people that have healthy weight do not have optimal metabolic health.
但是这并不仅仅代表说只有超重的人才有这个啊新陈代谢健康的问题。那最近的这个研究表明，2/3的体重正常的人也会有这个啊新陈代谢健康的问题。
All right, so metabolic health. If you're healthy metabolically, actually, it makes you more resilient. Your health is more resilient.
所以说，如果说你的新陈代谢健康的话，它会让你的身体对这个外界的这个影响反应的会啊、恢复的会更快。
So, for example, if you eat, a few donuts. Let's say you eat a few donuts. So there's a lot of sugar and there's a lot of fat in the donut. That's why they taste so good.
所以说，假如说这个你今天吃了两三个甜甜圈，那这个甜甜圈里面呢是有非常多的糖分和脂肪。那也就是为什么这个甜甜圈吃起来这么美味。
And this graph here shows what happens to the glucose in your blood after you eat that donut.
所以右边这张图呢，就是显示了你的这个血糖的反应，当你吃了这个甜甜圈以后。
Now, if you have healthy metabolic health, then you are the purple line.
如果你的新陈代谢健康的话，那你的这个血糖的这个水平呢，就是紫色的这条线。
You eat the donut, it tastes good, the blood sugar level rises a little bit, but then very quickly, within a half hour, starts to go down back to the normal baseline.
那你吃完这个甜甜圈以后呢，你的这个血糖指数会升高一点，但是30分钟以后呢，它就会很快的降下来到这个啊、普通正常的这个血糖值。
But if you are kind of like a normal American and you're watching too much TV, you don't exercise very much, you're stressed, you're not sleeping.
但是如果
说 then you're the red line.
但是如果说呢，你是有像这个很普遍的这个美国人，你就很经常久坐，然后经常看电视不运动，那你的这个新陈代谢有可能就不是那么好，那你就是很有可能就是红色的这一条线。
So you eat the donut, it tastes just as good, but the blood sugar level is not very well controlled. It keeps going higher.And it doesn't return to the normal baseline for a long time.
所以说呢，你吃完这个甜甜圈以后呢，当然啦，也是同样美味，但是你的血糖指数会继续上升，而且会维持很高，它不会立刻就降下来。
All right, so, you know, going back to that conversation that we had, you know, with the scientists 20 years ago, we realized that the best thing that you could do for metabolic health is lifestyle changes.
所以说呢，当这个科学家研究了很久以后，他们得出来的结论就是为了去改善你的这个啊新陈代谢健康，你能做的最好的事情就是去改善你的生活习惯。
Because metabolic health is a spectrum, right? So if you have poor lifestyle choices, then your metabolic health will not be good.
所以说呢，这个新陈代谢健康实际上就像一个光谱一样。如果说你的这个生活方式不健康，那它就会偏向左边。
So we need to sort of be more like where the green arrow is. We need to have more regular exercise and healthy diet and adequate sleep, etc.
所以说呢，我们需要把我们的这个生活的方式转移成这个屏幕右边，经常去做运动，然后呢要饮食平衡，然后要足够的睡眠。
And let's hope that, you know, I'm looking into the audience and you all look pretty healthy. So congratulations, I think. It looks like you're making a lot of healthy lifestyle choices.
所以说呢，他说他有看到这个在座的大家，大家看起来都很健康。所以说呢，大家已经是在做，已经有了一个非常，他认为大家已经有了一个非常健康的生活方式。
But remember, you probably still also have stress and some other things that sort of put you somewhere in the middle. Maybe not red, but you're probably somewhere in the middle.
但是呢，每一个人实际上，即便在你的生活健康很健，生活方式很健康的时候呢，你也会有非常多的压力，来自于外部的压力。所以说呢，非常有可能是把你的这个图谱，把你放在了这个图谱的中间。你可能并不是红色，但是呢，也不一定真的是绿色。
So let's assume that we are healthy and we want to be more healthy, better healthy metabolism.
所以说呢，那我们会认为说，所有的人，大家不单单是想要健康，而且是想要说更加健康，然后去维持更加健康这样的一种状态。
And you probably have some friends that feel the same way.
所以说呢，你肯定有很多伙伴朋友也是这样觉得的。
Now this is kind of, this may be new to you, some of this metabolic health, but I promise you.You'll see more and more news about this in the future. And so, what we can do, what Mother Nature can do to help you with this, will become more and more important.
所以说呢，大家一定会在这一方面有越来越多的重视。所以说呢，我们也会有越来越多这个科研，还有我们，还有这个大家，还有这个科学家，还有大自然会可以帮助大家做的也会越来越多。
So, about 7 years ago, my team and I started to become really more interested in these purple molecules that you find in purple grains and berries and vegetables and fruits.
所以大概七年前的时候呢 ，Mark 和他的团队啊开始在看这个水果和蔬菜当中有充满非常多的蓝紫色或者红色成分的这个水果和蔬菜。
So I know, for example, that in China you have purple corn and you have sometimes black rice.
所以比方说在中国会有紫薯，还有黑米。
These are very high in a molecule called anthocyanins.
那紫薯和这个黑米当中，它有非常非常多的花青素。
And you know, we eat less and less of these herbal molecules in a modern diet.
那在我们现在的这个生活方式和饮食当中，我们这个吃到的这个，我们平时食用的深色有紫色和红色的这个饮食是越来越少。
But our health authorities are starting to understand the importance. They have a health benefit.
但是呢，我们现在实际上可以越来越多的看到这个花青素对你的这个身体的这个益处有很多。
And scientists are tracing how much are people getting each day from their diet.
然后呢，科学家就开始去研究说，每天你平均摄入的花青素是多少。
So you see, in Australia, my countrymen are not doing too well. They have very low intake of purple molecules.
所以在澳洲呢，这个他们做的不是非常好，然后这个他们花青素的这个摄取量是非常低的。
And Tom Warren, they're doing
a little
bit
better.
所以中国呢比澳洲稍微好一点。
You know, in China, the government has actually now established a minimum daily level of about 85 milligrams per day. So it looks like, you know, in China, they're not even quite halfway there yet.
所以说呢，近期这个中国政府有这个规定说，或者建议说，每一个人每天的花青素摄取量要达到85。那现在的话呢，基本上他们的但真正这个中国它平均人口它的摄取量还没有到一半，还没有到这个建议的一半。
Now, 85 is a good goal, but I want to share with you now the research that we did that shows you that the best place to be is this purple bar here, about 215 milligrams per day.
所以说呢，那当然了，就85是一个非常好的数字。但是研究表明，如果你想要摄取花青素足够的量，到可以帮助你去改善你身体的这个新陈代谢呢，这个建议的量实际上是215毫克，215毫克每天。
So again, about 6 or 7 years ago, when we started to think, I wonder if these purple molecules have an impact on health, we did a study, a human study.
所以说在7年前呢，当他们想要真正的去求证说这个花青素对于这个血糖还有这个微生态的这个控制到底是不是真的有效，他们做了一个临床实验。
The aim of the study was to see if these purple molecules were actually a really good food for the healthy bacteria in the gut.
所以说呢，他们做这个临床实验的目标是要去证明说，这些含有紫色的这些成分是不是真的对你的这个肠胃健康有提高。
And the study was successful because you can see from this graph that basically we showed that if you eat a lot of these purple molecules, that you'll have more of the healthy bacteria in the GI tract and less of the unhealthy bacteria.
所以说呢，这个临床实验是非常成功的。大家可以看到说，如果说你经常食用这个含有紫色、红色的这个食物的话，你肠胃里面健康的好的细菌是增加了，然后不好的细菌呢是减少了。
Now, every time we do a human study, we also like to do safety. So we do a blood draw, just like your doctor would do, and we measure the metabolic biomarkers of health.
所以说呢，每一次当我们这个做临床实验，还有非常重要的一点就是安全。所以说呢，他们也有和医生一样，然后呢，对这个参与临床实验的人去进行了抽血，然后测试了他们这个新陈代谢健康的指标。
And here's an example of something that we found that we thought was very exciting.
那这个呢，他们就在这个测试当中了，发现一个让他们非常兴奋的一个结果。
If your body doesn't control blood sugar very well, just like that red line that we saw earlier.
如果说你的这个身体对这个血糖控制的不是很好，就像我们前面那张图里面红色的那条曲线。
Then that sugar sticks to the protein that is in your body.
那这个血糖就会和你身体里面的这个蛋白质相粘连。
When the sugar sticks to the protein, it makes the protein have a sticky end, and then it starts to stick to the other proteins in the body.
所以说，当你的这个血糖和一个这个脂肪粘连了以后呢，它就会变得更粘连，就会和其他的脂肪粘在一起。
And that process is called glycation.
那这个过程叫做 glycation.
yep.That's good. And what that does basically is it ages you much faster.
所以说这个 glycation, 回头我去 Google 一下是什么意思。这个 glycation 它对你身体产生的影响就是让你老化的这个更快。
So for example, if you see wrinkles on your face or in your body, that is a result of protein glycation, where the proteins stick and then they don't unstick, so the result maybe is a wrinkle.
所以说呢，当你看到你的这个额头上或者脸上有产生皱纹，有皱纹的时候，这个就是可以啊，这个就是由这个脂肪的这个 glycation 的那个过程导致的，它就粘在了一起。
And when that happens inside your body, for example, it makes your blood vessels more stiff and causes problems.
那如果说它当然了，它在你的身体里面去这个越来越多这样性发生了以后呢，它还有可能会造成你的这个血管硬化，然后呢就会造成更多的身体健康问题。
So when we looked at the safety data of the study and we saw this, we saw that the anthocyanins were actually lowering the rate of glycation.
所以说呢，当他们做这个验血的时候，就发现说这个花青素会的花青素呢，让你的身体减少了这个血糖和这个脂肪做的这个 glycation 的这个问题。
When we saw this and a lot of other really good data on the safety of metabolism, we realized that, wait a minute, these anthocyanins are doing much more than just making healthy microbes in the gut. They are also changing and making your metabolism more healthy.
所以说呢，当他们去做这个方面的研究的时候，他们一开始只是认为说花青素可能只是对你的这个肠胃健康有好处，但是呢，这个实验就证明了说，实际上花青素不仅仅只是在帮你做肠胃健康的调节，而是对你整个身体的这个新陈代谢健康都有影响。
So before this experiment, we thought that the only thing you could do to improve your metabolic health was lifestyle and diet, like I shared with you before.
所以说，在这个实验之前，他们认为说，唯一可以去改善你新陈健康。新陈代谢健康的方式就是去改善你的生活方式。
Now we realize that nature does have a secret, and that we can help improve metabolic health with these purple molecules.
那现在他们发现大自然中实际上自然有了一个解决方法，就是通过这个花青素来帮大家去改善你们的这个新陈代谢健康。
We started to look at the scientific literature.And sure enough, we found even more evidence that this was true.
那他们就开始了更多这个调研，就发现说这个的确是真实的，他们的这个猜想。
So for example, here you see four different tissues in the body, right? The fat, the muscle, the pancreas, the liver.
所以说这里大家可以看到四种身体里面的脂肪，组织有脂肪组织、肌肉组织，还有胰腺组织和肝脏组织。
And actually, there are hundreds of markers of metabolic health, and we looked at all of them.
实际上呢，这个去展示这个，去了解这个新陈代谢健康的指标，实际上不止一个，是有上百个。所以说，他们是有去查看了上百个这样子的指标。
And the science shows that if you have a diet rich in these anthocyanins, then in the fatty tissue.You see improvements in fatty acid oxidation and insulin sensitivity.
所以说呢，他们发现说，当你的这个身体摄入很多这个紫色的、深紫色的这种成分，你的这个身体里面的脂肪酸的氧化和胰岛素的敏感性都会有提高。
Same in the muscle. If you have a diet rich in anthocyanins, you saw improvements in metabolism in the muscle.
那在这个肌肉组织里面，我们也发现说，如果说你有摄取多的这个紫色的成分的话呢，你的这个葡萄糖的摄取和这个糖代谢也有加速。
Same in the pancreas. We saw, for example, blood lipids go down in the pancreas if you have a diet rich in anthocyanins. That's a good thing.
那在胰腺组织里面呢，也看到有这个。beta 细胞的功能有提升，还有血脂有降低。
And in the liver also, and the anthocyanins improve the metabolism in the liver.
那在肝脏组织里面呢，有看到这个脂肪堆积和氧化压力都有减少。
So my team got together and we looked at the literature and we did a big map, what you call a heat map, of many of the markers of metabolism to see what happens when you have a diet rich in anthocyanins.
所以说呢，他和他的团队就在一起做了一个叫做热力图，就是看这个花青素对你的这个身体组织里面的这个影响。
So here are four different tissues, and you can see for each of the tissues, we have, you know, 10 or so markers of metabolic health.
所以说呢，这里有四种不同的这个刚刚我们看到的身体组织，每一个身体组织里面呢，他们就有看去观察了十个新陈代谢健康指标。
So the diet that was rich in anthocyanins, for example, in the liver, in that first marker, it increased CPT1A.
所以说呢，就比方说在这个肝脏组织里面，如果你有经常食用足够的这个花青素，就会看到这个 CPT-1A 这个指标的上升。
And in the liver, you see RBP4 went down.
还有这个叫 RBP4 有减少
and so on.
啊，还有以及更多。
Now the question is this good or bad?
那接下来的问题就是说呢，这到底是好是坏呢？
So we compared it with the literature for people who are metabolically healthy.
所以说呢，他们去把这个和这个有健康的这个新陈代谢的人的这个同样的指标去做了一个对比。
So these are people, for example, that are physically active, that are eating a healthy diet, and they're not smoking, etc.
那这一类型的人呢，就是他有经常运动，然后呢有非常好的饮食，然后呢也不会去抽烟，就是有非常好的这个生活习惯。
And as you can see, it's almost the same. It's not exact, but you can see that the anthocyanins have the same effect on metabolic health.As people who are exercising and being very healthy.
所以说呢，大家可以看到这个不完全一样，但几乎是一样的。就是说，这个服用足够的花青素的人和这个平时保持非常好的这个生活习惯的人是几乎是非常相似的。
So at this point, you know, the scientists are very happy. We are opening the champagne.We are, you know, getting drunk together because we have just discovered something very exciting.
所以说呢，这个时候呢，科学家呢就非常的高兴。他们发现这个以后呢，这个时候就是他们一起开香槟啊，一起喝酒庆祝的时候，大家可以笑一下。
干杯！
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 So actually, no, we didn't drink alcohol because that's not good for our metabolic health.
所以呢，他会开玩笑啦。他们当然没有真的去喝香槟，因为这个对你的新陈代谢健康是没有好处的。
But we were very happy, and so we asked the company, "Hey, we need some more money to study this. This is very interesting."
但是呢，他们的确有和这个公司做完这个研究以后呢，有和公司反映说，这个是一个非常令人激动的一项这个。研究，那他们就申请了更多的经费去做进一步的研究。
So for the past 7 years, these are the types of studies that we did, and I want to share just a few with you.
所以说呢，在过去的七年当中，这个呢就是他们所做的这个研究，他会想要分享几个和给大家。
Alice, how much time do we have left?
We have 28 minutes.
Great, thank you. All right, that's perfect. All right, everyone, let's talk about these studies that we did.
好，那我们先来讲一下这个他们所做的研究。
First, you know, these purple molecules are a family. You can see in the picture on the left here, you know, the molecules look very similar, but they're slightly different.
所以说呢，这个他们就是在不断的需要测验，找到精准的这个花青素。那在左边的这些食物呢，全部都是富含花青素，但是呢，又他们的这个分子结构又会稍稍有不同。
And the types of purple molecules that are in, say, the blueberry might be a little bit different to the ones that we find in the purple rice.
那在这个蓝莓中发现的这个花青素和这个在紫米当中发现的花青素，它们实际上是不太一样的。
So, just spoiler alert, this is what we found: that the purple molecules that are in the black currant, the bilberry, and the black rice were the best.
所以说呢，他们到最后发现了这个在这个黑加仑和越橘还有紫米当中的这个花青素是最好的。
I'll show you how we found that out.
那他这里给大家看一下是怎么发现的。
We had some cells in a petri dish, and these were the same kinds of cells that you find in the GI tract.
所以说呢，他们在市民当中呢有一些细胞，那这些细胞呢是你在这个肠道当中会发现的、会看到的细胞。
And we fed those cells the different kinds of purple molecules in the family.
那他在这个细胞当中呢有发现不同种类的这个花青素。
And then we sort of added something to the tissue culture that normally makes the cells very angry and upset and damages them.
所以说呢，他们在这个细胞当中，在这个市民的细胞当中加了一些成分，然后呢，这些成分呢是会让这个细胞有非常大的这个不良反应。
And we wanted to see which of the purple molecules was best at protecting the cells.
所以说呢，他们就看在这个市民当中是哪一种这个花青素的分子结构是最好的保护了这个细胞。
And you see, we found these purple ones here are the best, cyanidin and delphinidin.
所以说呢，他们最终就发现这个矢车菊素和飞燕草素的活性是最高、最有效的。
And you see, the black line is the cells that didn't have help from these molecules, and it's not very happy.
那所以这个黑色的这一条线呢，就是没有受到任何这个花青素保护的，所以说他们的这个健康是最不好的。
And as I mentioned earlier, the fruits, the place that you can get these the most is from the black currant, the blueberry, the black rice.
那这个我们刚刚讲到的这个保护到细胞最好的这个矢车菊素和飞燕草素，就是来自于这三种食物。
Okay, so now that we have the best source, we chose the dose, 215 milligrams, and we looked at how they're able to.Protect the GI. We did more studies.
那当我们发现了，当我们发现说哪一个类型、哪一个分子结构的花青素是最好的时候呢？那我们接下来就要去做这个研究，看它对这个肠道谁对哪一个对肠道保护的作用是最佳的。
So this study was not done in a test tube. Now this is done in mice. These are healthy mice. But if you give healthy mice like a lot of bad food like donuts, then you can see a big impact on the GI.
那这个实验就不是在这个市民当中做的，而是在这个健康的小白鼠身上做的实验。那这个黑色的这个就是没有使用花青素，然后呢，他们会每天喂这个小白鼠非常不健康的饮食，比方说像甜甜圈啊这样一类食物。
So what we're really measuring here is how much stuff can get through our gut wall and into our body and into our blood.
所以说他们在这个实验要观察的是，当这个小白鼠摄取了这样子的食物以后，有多少可以穿透这个肠胃的这个肠胃壁，然后进入到我们的身体当中。
So let's pause for a minute because I want to help you to understand this. It's very important.
所以这里的话，他想要多花一点时间来解释，因为这个非常重要。
When you consider your body, your skin, you know, is on the outside, right?
所以说，当你看到一个人的时候，你可以看到他的皮肤，这个是他的皮肤，这个是他的外在。
Let's say that you take off your shoes and socks, and you are walking through a really dirty street, or maybe even a sewer.
那比方说，你现在假如说你把鞋子脱掉，然后呢，你就在这个光脚、赤脚在路上走路，或者甚至是走过一滩这个非常脏的积水。
Does that sound like fun?
觉得听起来很有趣吗？这个活动。
So you know your skin is doing a really good job of protecting you from all of the germs and the bacteria and that's in the mud or the sewer.
所以说你的皮肤实际上是做了一个对你的身体做一个非常好的保护功能，去防止这个地上的这些细菌啊、脏东西啊穿透到你的这个身体里面来。
You'll probably be okay. You go home and have a shower and you're healthy and fine.
所以说呢，你就回家洗个澡，把脚洗一洗，那实际上你就还是跟之前一样健康。
Now imagine if you have some sores, some kind of wounds, maybe cuts in your feet.
但如果你想象一下，如果说你的脚上当时是有一个伤口，有一个伤口或者有一个裂痕。
What do you think now about walking barefoot through the sewer?
那你觉得这个时候你光脚走在这个积水里面，你觉得这个时候会发生什么？很脏的积水，它实际上是个下水道的水。
哇。
Oh, not good, right?
Right.
Because the skin can't protect you now from the bacteria, and they're going to get into your body and cause an infection.
所以说这个时候呢，如果说你的脚上有伤口，那就会导致细菌进入到你的身体，然后造成炎症。
Okay, now think about your insides, your GI tract.
那现在想象你的这个肠，身体里面的这个肠胃道，肠道。
Is your mouth inside or outside?
你的嘴是在你的身体的内部还是外部？
Outside.
Yeah, it's kind of outside, right? Because you can put food in there, bacteria can get in there, right? And so it's outside.
所以说你的嘴是你在你的身体的外部，你可以通过它去摄取食物，然后呢，细菌也会通过你的嘴进入到你的身体。
Now, when does it stop being outside? Because now there's a pipe, and it goes down into your tummy, and then down into your intestines. Is that pipe inside or outside?
所以你的这个嘴部的这个食物的这个从什么时候开始变成了一个内部的？它从食物从你的嘴，然后进到你的这个食管，进到你的胃，进入你的肠道。从什么时候开始，它是变成了一个内部的一个器官
？Yeah, it's actually still outside. And actually, the further down you go, the more and more bacteria. And in fact, in the GI, in the colon, it is the highest concentration.Of bacteria, you know, known to man, it is very dense in bacteria.
所以说呢，实际上在你不断的这个，就是你的这个，在你摄取食物，然后吃东西的时候，喝水的时候，实际上它还是一个外部的一个过程。当你的这个食物在你的身体里面越来越往下的时候，进入你的肠道，实际上里面是有非常多的细菌。那实际上这个你的肠道里面是这个身体里面细菌最多的一个地方。
So, the surface area inside the GI tract, the colon and the intestines, is about the same as two tennis courts.
So you are saying the length of your intestines is two sides of the tennis court?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, like that's the surface area. So think of the skin and think of the inside when you roll it out. It's going to be about the same surface area as two tennis courts.
所以说呢，每一个人正常人，你的这个肠道的面积，实际上如果你把它全部铺开的话，是相当于两个网球场那么大。
But and just like your skin.It has to be intact because you don't want any of that bacteria or any of those toxins to leave the GI tract and get into the bloodstream.
所以说呢，就像你的皮肤一样，你希望说这个肠道是健康的，是没有任何这个伤口的。这样子的话呢，才能保证你的身体，你的这个肠道里面的细菌不会进入到你的身体。
So this is why we are studying GI protection, and now hopefully you can understand this graph.
所以说呢，他们才要去研究这个肠道保护的这一项研究。那这样的话呢，大家就可以更容易的去理解这张图。
We can measure how good that GI is protecting you from bacteria and stopping that leakiness.
所以说这样子的话呢，他们就可以更好的去了解到说这个对你肠道的保护作用的这个保护，这样呢就会尽量减少这个叫做肠道通透性，尽量减少。
So we showed in these studies that the anthocyanins help to make that nice and tight, so the bacteria and toxins and things don't leave the GI tract and get into the body.
所以说呢，他们就发现这个花青素对于这个肠道保护的这个作用是做得非常好的。这样子的话呢，你就不会有细菌从你的这个肠道进入到你的身体。
That's what all of these studies do.
所以呢，这个图下面这个整个这个研究就是在做这个当时就是在做这个指标的一个研究。
Now remember another marker of metabolic health is how your body handles glucose, and this series of studies that we did showed that anthocyanins help your body to control the glucose metabolism.
那另外一个这个对于这个新陈代谢健康的这个研究，就是有关于这个你的身体对胰岛素的抵抗的改善。那这个图呢，就是这个研究。
And also, remember I talked about how metabolic health indicators are lipids.
那这张图在我们刚刚前面呢，就讲到说花青素对于这个肝脏健康的保护。那这下面这个三个图就是这个对于改善这个肝脏健康。
A common thing if you're not metabolically healthy is that you have a bigger buildup of fat in the liver.
所以如果说你的这个新陈代谢健康不良的话，那你在你的这个肝脏里面就会更容易有脂肪堆积。
So on the left here, you see a picture of a slice of the healthy liver, and you can see it's a nice pink color.
所以说呢，最左边的这张图就是一个健康的这个脂肪的一个切片，所以大家可以看起来是一个非常密集的这个粉色。
Now these mice in the middle here, they had a very unhealthy diet, unhealthy lifestyle, and you can see these little white things. This is more lipid that's accumulating in the liver. It's like a fatty liver.
那中间这张图呢，就是一个生活就是一个这个饮食不健康的。然后呢，大家可以看到有很多这个白色的小点点，那实际上这个就是这个脂肪的这个堆积。
On the right, these are mice that also had an unhealthy lifestyle, but we supplemented them with lots of these purple molecules, the anthocyanins.
那最右边的这张图呢，也是一个这个饮食还有这个生活习惯不健康的这一个人。那他们做了，但是呢，不同的区别就是他有给他服用了这个很多有紫色成分的这样子的食物。
And so you can see that the anthocyanins have protected the liver and make it look much more like the normal healthy liver.
所以呢，你可以看到说这个花青素呢是保护了你的这个。肝脏，让它看起来和这个健康的这个人的肝脏，实际上他们的这个反应是一样的。
Again, this is one of those results that made the team very excited that we were starting to understand now the power of these purple molecules to protect your health.
那所有呢，这个研究也是让他们的团队感到非常兴奋的。这个就是让他们理解到了这个花青素对于你的这个肝脏的这个保护。
So we did another study now. This is the one that I described earlier in humans. I gave you a little preview of it before.
那这个的话就是刚刚他有讲到的这个这个花青素对于这个血糖的这个调节。
So basically, I wanted to share this again because this was an 8-week study. So that's 2 months on anthocyanins showing the impact.
所以这个呢是一个8周的一个实验，所以说就是2个月，然后呢来展现这个花青素对于你身体健康的这个正面的影响。
But we ask ourselves the question, well, if it's so powerful, how quickly does the effect take place? Do you have to wait 8 weeks, or do you start to see a fairly immediate effect of these anthocyanins on health?
那所以说呢，这个时候呢，他们会有一个问题，就是那你说到说花青素这么厉害，这么有用，那是不是我也要一直要等到8周2个月以后才可以看到效果
？So for this study, we got 25 healthy individuals. These were college students, about somewhere between 20 and 35 years old.
所以说呢，他们做了一个另外的一个研究，就是找到了25个健康的从19到35岁之间的这个人。
And for this study, we made these poor students eat like a really big breakfast with a lot of fat on it. They had to eat everything that's on this plate here, and some of them just kind of felt sick and didn't want to eat it. So it was kind of very unhealthy, but we made them do it.
所以说呢，我们做了一个这个，在我们请了这个志愿者，然后在这个志愿者的这个同意下做了这样子的一个实验。那这个呢，就是每天早晨就让他们吃这个图片上的这个食物，然后很多人呢，实际上会觉得这个实际上他并不喜欢，然后看到以后就会觉得有想反胃的感觉，但是 这些可怜的人，他们就因为他们参加了实验，所以说他们一定要吃。
And then we took blood samples for the next 5 hours, and we sort of followed some of those same metabolic health markers that we were talking about earlier.
所以说在他们吃完了以后，他们等了5个小时，然后就去测量他们的这个新陈代谢指标。
And then a couple of weeks later, we got them all to come back, and this time we gave them 215 milligrams of these anthocyanins.And they did the same thing, and we followed the blood again.
然后在几周以后呢，又把这同样的一批人把他请回来。然后呢，这个时候的区别呢，是我们有给他们215毫克的花青素，但是呢，其他任何行为都不变，还是会和之前一样吃这种高脂肪、高热量的食物。
And here again are the results that we see.And basically, you have here 4 different ways of measuring metabolic health biomarkers.
所以这个呢，就是他们做出来的这个实验，是有4种不同的方式去测量你的这个新陈代谢健康。
And so, for example, you see plasma endotoxins. So this means some of those nasty things from the bacteria that are leaving the GI tract and getting into the blood.
所以这个呢，就是一个指数。这个指数的意思就是你的这个有哪一些不好的细菌是进入到了你的身体里面。
And you can see that those individuals that had anthocyanins in their diet were more protected.
那大家可以看到，有服用了这个花青素的人，他是他的这个肠道是受到更加好的保护。
Now this experiment here.This one's like that purple line, red line that I showed you earlier. And you can see that the anthocyanins sort of lowered that curve and helped the blood glucose curve to return to normal much more quickly.
那这个左下方的这个图呢，实际上就和大家刚开始看的这个曲线是一样的，是它的这个血糖反应。那左边黑色的就是没有服用花青素。然后右边呢，就是服用了花青素以后，它的血糖反应的这个下降的这个速度。
On the bottom right, you can see we're measuring triglycerides, right? That's a kind of blood lipid. And we see again that the purple molecules help to protect and lower those levels of blood lipids after that awful diet.
然后在这个屏幕的左下、右下方的这张图呢，就是测量这个甘油三酯的这一项指标。那同样的，我们可以看到这个紫色的这个有服用了花青素的话呢，它就是这个指标会被保护得更好。
Right, so that was a lot of graphs. So let's just summarize here the 7 years of work that we did in these 4 points.
所以说呢，我们刚刚讲到了非常多的这个研究，那接下来我们总结一下，把这7年的这个所有的研究总结在一起。
First, we try to find what is the right type of these purple molecules that is most effective.
首先我们找到了哪一类型的花青素对我们身体这个新陈代谢健康的改善最有效。
And then we did a bunch of studies to show how if you have that right dose and the right type of purple molecule that you can help your metabolic health.
接下来呢，我们做了很多这个研究，就是说这个花青素是如何帮助你的身体去改善你的这个从各种指标从血糖到胰岛素到血脂各种指标来看，它是如何保护你的这个新陈代谢健康的。
And those studies also sort of help to unlock or explain how these purple molecules work, and they work somehow by protecting the GI.
那这个接下来呢，我们也了解到说它是如何去做到这样子的保护呢？那它就是去保护你的这个肠胃壁的这个健康。
And the studies also showed that you know if you eat these purple molecules for a long time, there is a benefit. But we also showed that there's an immediate benefit as well.
那如果另外一个呢，就是说当你去服用花青素的时候呢，大家会看到健康，但除了它对你身体健康有好处以外，它会是有一个立刻即时的一个健康的这个提高。
Right, so this is a little bit how we think it works.
所以这里呢，我们认为是它是如何工作的这个花青素。
So these here are the cells that line the gastrointestinal tract, right? You see four cells here.
所以这里呢，首先大家可以看到是肠上皮细胞，这样四个细胞。
And so you can see the fingers on the cells, right? These little, they're called villi. They're like fingers.
然后呢，接下来呢，大家可以看到一个一个像手指一样的东西，那个叫做 villi， 这样一个像手指的这个组织。
And you can't see it, but actually each finger has more fingers on them, so they're called microvilli.
所以说呢，每一个像手指一样，大家看不到，但是每一个像手指一样的这个组织呢，它上面有更多像手指一样的这样的组织，叫做。
So the purpose of that is to increase the surface area so that you can absorb all your food, and you know the gut does amazing things.
所以说呢，它要做这个花青素，它会做的呢，就是把这些像手指一样东西，把它做一个紧密的连接，这样子的话呢，去保护这个你的肠胃壁。
Remember the surface area of two tennis courts.
所以大家就是回过头来记得说，你的这个肠道壁的这个面积是相当于是两个网球场这么大，要保护这些所有的这个肠胃壁。
And it's all exposed to these different bacteria. It's like a sewer in there. All these bacteria and all these toxins are touching this single layer of cells.
那所有这个在肠道里面的这个叫做肠道菌，他们是有非常非常多的这个肠道菌，这个它几乎就像是这个下水道里面的这个细菌一样。
Now, if you have a healthy lifestyle and if you have a healthy diet, then these cells will be healthy and nothing will get through.
那如果说你有一个健康的生活方式，那你的这个肠道壁就会很健康，那没有细菌会穿透到你的，会渗透到你的这个身体里面。
What I mean is nothing bad, because actually these cells can let in the food and the vitamins and minerals and all the good things, but keep out the bacteria and the toxins.
那当然了，它这里是说把坏的这个细菌留在外面，你身体里面呢吸收进去的这个营养还有这个维生素是会渗透到你的体内的。
So this modern stressful lifestyle that we have, it causes changes in the bacteria here.And it also causes changes in the ability of the cells to stop the bad things from getting in.
所以说呢，我们现在的这个现代生活方式呢，就会去对这个肠道菌群造成一些变化。然后呢，它也会去改变这个你的这个肠道壁里面的这个紧密的这个结构。
And if the bad things get in, it's just like walking barefoot in the sewer with cuts on your feet.You cause a sort of toxic situation.
那如果说这个有细菌穿透到你的这个身体当中呢，实际上就相当于你是光脚走在这个下水道里面，会有细菌进入到你的身体，它叫做内毒素会进入到血液，然后呢就会造成这个炎症的反应。
And that toxic situation then actually just upsets all of the biochemistry of your body, and so you end up with what we call.Metabolic dysfunction or unhealthy metabolism.
那当这些这个内毒素进入血液以后呢，到最终就会造成这个你的体内的各种这个器官的代谢失调。
So this is how the anthocyanins work. They are like a superfood for the GI barrier function.
那所以说呢，这个就是花青素它是如何工作的。它相当于是给你的这个肠道屏障功能的一种超级食物。
So anyone here know what is a BFF? Do you have a BFF in your life?
所以每个人都有你们自己的 BFF 吗？
Yes.
有。Yes.
Yeah, best friends forever, right?
Yes. Best friends.
Right. So think about it like this. See here, GI barrier function is the GIBF.
所以说这个我们的这个肠道屏障的这个健康就叫做 GIBF， 就是你的这个肠道的最好的朋友。
So anthocyanins are helping you to have a GIBFF.
所以你的这个花青 素呢，就是你的这个 GIBFF， 就是你肠道屏障健康永远最好的朋友。
Hashtag GIBFF。
OK，Hashtag， 大家都知道。
So the anthocyanins help promote the healthy microbiome, and they promote these tight junctions in the GI tract.
所以说呢，花青素就会促进健康的这个微生态和促进肠道之间的紧密连接。
And this is how it supports your metabolic health.
然后呢，从它这样以来呢，就可以去降低身体的这个内毒素。
So thank you so much for letting me share with you the science